Hello everyone, it's Stephen Whiteside here from theuptrend.com with this week's edition of Protect Your Portfolio. In this presentation, we take a longer-term look at the North American stock markets using weekly charts. Let's start off today with a quick housekeeping announcement. We're going to be closed on Monday. No charts on Monday, no videos on Tuesday morning. We will do charts on Tuesday night, and I'll be back to speak to you again on Wednesday morning. Now, the headline from last week is that the market made new all-time highs before closing lower on the week. Those lows were just fractionally lower. There's really no reason to get overly concerned. In fact, the VIX made a new low last week, which of course is supportive for higher stock prices. It did close higher, but we're still trending lower here. I never care about the absolute value of the VIX. I just care about which way it's trending. If we come back here and this coming Friday we close above $12.46, then I would certainly be concerned about the health of the stock market. There's the S&P 500, made a new all-time high last week before closing down just 44 cents. This coming Friday, we need to close below 2411.49 to give us a new weekly sell signal. Not expecting that to happen. We're 28 points away from hitting 2500. I think we should be able to do that on Monday or Tuesday. We are coming into month end, and that usually has a bullish bias to it. There's the NASDAQ 100 making a new all-time high last week before closing down just $12. Still trading above the upper channel line, so no concern there. Looking north of the border, you may have read this headline, Canada's economy to lead the G7. Of course, how is the stock market rewarded for that? Of course, we are the worst performing stock market. So obviously there's a big disconnect with the reality of the Canadian economy and how its stock market is doing. And so to try to make things as simple as possible, all we want to do is follow the money and not try to predict where we think things are going to go. A year ago, if you had predicted that the Canadian economy was going to be the best, and so that's where you should put all your money, well, you know, you would have been greatly disappointed unless you're shorting the market. There's no direct correlation between how an economy does and how the stock market does. There's a lot of other variables, and money is liquid. It can move very quickly from one asset class to another. That's not the same as personal real estate. It's not the same as your job. We don't have that liquidity. We don't have that mobility, but the stock market does. And so that's why we just want to follow the money and not worry about news and forecasts and analysis. So for the TSX, we're looking at the market in the opposite direction. It's still on a weekly sell signal, and we need a close this coming Friday above 15,419.73. Not expecting that to happen, unfortunately. And week after week, that upper trend line is going to continue to move lower. Now, there's three themes that I think are going to unwind here over the next couple of months. First of all, I'm looking for weakness in the financial services banking sector. Here's the Dow Jones Banking Index, and it still has not taken out the recent high, and certainly has not taken out the high from back in February. Now, if you're playing the XLF, we're still stuck at $25 resistance, and we've been there for 6 weeks now. And so looking to see if we can break out and take out last week's high, for instance. On the week, we closed at 24.91. For the high of the week, it was 25.32. So if we start breaking out above 25.32, that should take us up to 26.56 as the next target. But obviously, 25 is a big round number, and the market is having trouble with it. Looking at the Canadian financial services, there's the high from RSP season. And now it looks like 3 weeks ago we put in a lower high. Now we're coming down. We traded down to the lower channel line. This coming Friday, a close below 280.84 would give us a new weekly sell signal for the Canadian financial services sector. Now, the other part of our theme is that commodity prices and commodity stocks should rise. There's the TSX Energy Index up over 4% on the week. There's the U.S. Amex Oil and Gas Index up over 2.5% on the week. Looking at gold stocks, the XAU back on a weekly buy signal up over 2% on the week. The TSX Gold Index not faring as well, up 1.20% on the week. There's the price of gold up $14 back on a weekly buy signal. There's crude oil up over 8%, close to 9% on the week. So huge move up for crude oil back on a weekly buy signal there. The U.S. dollar continues to move lower. Canadian dollar closing above 80 cents on Friday. Now, one area that I want you to watch very closely is the transports. There's the Dow Transport Index. It peaked 3 weeks ago, came down hard last week, creating a new weekly sell signal for the transports. Airlines came down hard last week and put a lot of pressure on the transport index, down over 5%. There's air freight down sharply, still on a weekly buy signal. The railroads, second week of a weekly sell signal, and railroads continued to move lower. And last up, the trucking sector. So all part of the transports, they were down hard. Not enough to generate a sell signal, but you can see pressure across the board there. And along with financial services, this could be an area of the market that's starting to crack and could put pressure on the rest of the market going forward. Okay, folks, that's all for this week's presentation. Major U.S. indices still on weekly buy signals. Canadian market still on a weekly sell signal, but we are expecting the energy sector and gold and precious metals to continue to move higher. Have a great day, and if you're not with us during the week, have a great week. Otherwise, next time you'll hear my voice is on Wednesday morning.